Good morning, everyone. It's Danny O'Neill again. How are you? So, you all know what I do. I coach organizations and businesses on performance and wellness. And generally speaking, when my clients come to me, they come to me for, initially at least, for weight loss, maybe some difficulties with type 2 diabetes, maybe a little bit of a heart scare. And then over time, I work them closer to what their core issues are and what really could be affecting them. We lose a couple pounds, we take the pressure off the type 2 diabetes, we get a little better food, we get a little better rest. And then inevitably, if somebody wants to stay and do some real work, we start talking about deeper things. We talk about relationships. We talk about feeling isolated, being senior executives. We talk about finding a way to make every day just a little fun. You know, not every day needs to be so serious. Senior executives tend to be serious folks, but we also can't be the proverbial one-trick ponies. You know, great at one thing and not have a life in the other areas of our life. And that includes our family, but you know, I think one of the things that I'm often hesitant to talk about early, but I've just consciously made the decision that I'm going to talk about it now amongst all of you folks who are watching this vlog, and that's our sexual energy. In our culture, we tend to really confuse most people about sexuality, when in reality, it's a very core portion of our being. In most of the Eastern traditions, life force and sexual energy are one and the same. It is what animates us. It's what really not only gets us excited just physically, but that excitation also applies to everything in life. It's what gets us to enjoy things. I don't think we talk about it enough here. So here's one thing I'm going to suggest: more sex. If you're not finding it, or if you're, you know, look, for those of us that were born in the late 40s and the 50s and the 60s, we're now at a stage where we could be convinced that maybe our sex life is over, maybe it's just diminishing, maybe it will never be the same, or maybe it was not that good in the first place. So I'm here to tell you that in every case, and there are a few exceptions with legitimate medical issues that are pre-existing, but in the vast majority of places, I mean the vast majority of times, you're just beginning. It's a story we tell ourselves. And that applies to both men and women. You know, I have friends and clients who are perimenopausal, and some look at it as a death sentence, and others look more openly as to what other things can happen. A lot of men certainly don't want to admit that they're slowing down or they're having difficulty getting erections. But it does happen a lot, and most often it has to do with food, exercise, relaxation, really understanding how to be present, and really, as my friend Jenna LaFlemme says, understanding your animal. You know, what's deep inside you. And it's all still there. It's all still there to the day we die. So it needs to be talked about. It needs to be engaged in. Now, and sex is healthy. It helps heart conditions. There's a good friend of mine, Dr. Gloria Brahm, who wrote a book called The Truth About Sex. She's been a longtime sexologist and is just unbelievable in this area. And there's a list of 18, and at the bottom of this blog, there will be a link to her site that will give you these 18 major reasons why sex is good. And we also need to look at, you know, so much of what occurs is that we emotionally trip ourselves up, sexually and otherwise, but certainly sexually. We trick ourselves into believing that somehow it's not okay to have pleasure. Well, pleasure is good. Pleasure is what we're here for. It helps us to be healthier. It helps us to be present. And all of that, is, if you watched me before or read me before, you know I always tie things back to making you perform better, giving you the gift of performance, and certainly in your business life. And I would submit that you can't do that in isolation. It's kind of like the one-trick pony thing again, right? It's got to happen throughout your life. I've had friends that are 50, 55 years old, they have a couple kids in college, and it suddenly dawns on them that even though they're CEOs or senior vice presidents, they don't have much of a relationship with them, and they're daunted by the possibility of how to get that back, or they just don't feel great in their body. So I'm going to be talking more about sex over a period of time, but I wanted to introduce the topic. I wanted to say that it's utterly crucial to your own health. I also want to say that there really is no type of sex unless it injures someone else that's inappropriate. The most frequent type of sex, and this is kind of hard for people to hear the first time, is self-sex. And that is such a huge opportunity for all of us to understand how we work, what feels good for us. And some have skipped over that step early in their lives in order to devote themselves to a career or family. This is a good time for us in our 40s and 50s and 60s to bring it back, be honest about it, and engage in that enjoyment. Be real. So we're going to talk about more later on. We're going to talk about bioidentical hormones, which help both men and women get through andropause and perimenopause. And we're going to talk about some of the emotional aspects too. So I hope you enjoyed this. Next week we're going to talk about innovation, one of my favorite topics. This is Danny O'Neill, and I'm your favorite wellness coach. See you soon.